trigger finger, also known as stenosing tenosynovitis. We will talk briefly about fingers' anatomy to understand how the trigger finger happens. The flexor tendons are long cord-like structures that attach the muscles of the forearm to the bones of the fingers. When the muscles contract, the flexor tendons allow the fingers to bend. Each of the flexor tendons passes through a tunnel in the palm and fingers that allows it to glide smoothly as the finger bends and straightens. This tunnel is called the tendon sheath. Along the tendon sheath, bands of tissue called pulleys, which are numbered A1 through A5, hold the flexor tendons closely to the finger bones. The thumb only has two annular pulleys that are described as A1 and A2 and one oblique. The pulley at the base of the finger is called the A1 pulley. This is the pulley that is most often involved in trigger finger. Trigger finger occurs when the pulley, A1, becomes too thick and inflamed, making it hard for the tendon to move freely through it with motion of the finger. Over time, the flexor tendon may also become inflamed and develop a small nodule. When the finger flexes and the nodule passes through the pulley, the bent finger may suddenly straighten with a pop. Based on the symptoms, trigger finger can be divided into four grades. First, there is pain and tenderness in your palm over the A1 pulley. There is no remarkable catching on physical examination. Later, there is a visible entrapment, but you are able to extend the finger actively. In advanced case, the finger becomes stuck firmly and requires using the opposite hand to straighten it. In severe cases, the finger may lock in a bent position and remain stuck in the palm despite attempts at straightening the finger. Causes and risk factors. In most cases, there is not a clear cause. Trigger finger can affect anyone, but women aged 40 to 60 have a higher risk of developing this condition. Trigger finger often occurs as a result of repetitive motion and overuse. For example, people are more likely to get trigger finger if their jobs require them to forcefully and repeatedly grasp tools such as gripping a steering wheel. Trigger finger is linked to certain medical conditions such as rheumatoid arthritis and gout. People with diabetes also have a higher risk of developing trigger finger. Symptoms. Pain in the palm at the base of a finger or thumb when it moves or is pressed on. A lump or bump at the base of your finger. A popping or clicking sensation when moving the affected finger. Stiffness in finger, inability to fully flex the finger. As the condition worsens, the finger or thumb may curl and get stuck, before straightening suddenly. Loss of the ability to bend or straighten the finger or thumb in advanced cases. These symptoms are at their worst right after waking up in the morning, as these are worse after periods of inactivity. Diagnosis. Your doctor will be able to diagnose a trigger finger by talking with you about your symptoms and examining your hand. Typically, X-rays or other tests are not needed. A physical examination will be used to diagnose trigger finger. Your consultant will ask you to open and close your hand and will check for evidence of locking and pain, as well as examining your palm for lumps. Treatment. Try to avoid activities that require repetitive gripping or the extended use of handheld vibrating tools for 3 to 4 weeks or until your symptoms improve. If you're not able to rest your hands completely, consider wearing padded gloves as you work. Non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs can help relieve pain and inflammation. Cold treatment can decrease pain and swelling by reducing blood flow to the affected area. Apply ice or a frozen gel pack to the affected finger and palm for 15 minutes 3 to 4 times a day. Gentle exercises and stretches can help improve movement in the affected finger, reduce stiffness and increase strength. Repeat this exercise 3 times throughout the day. Wearing a splint. The goal of splinting is to prevent the friction caused by flexor tendon movement through the affected A1 pulley until the inflammation there resolves. Consider wearing the splint at night, keeping your finger in an extended position, for up to 6 weeks. If your symptoms do not improve, your doctor might recommend corticosteroid injections. The doctor will inject the corticosteroid into the tendon sheath at the base of the affected thumb or finger with a small needle. Corticosteroid shots typically contain a local anesthetic to numb the area. Corticosteroid injections are usually effective for a year or longer. It is less successful in patients with long-standing disease, greater than 6 months duration. Multiple digit involvement. In patients with diabetes. In patients with diabetes, corticosteroid injections can cause a short-term rise in blood sugar, so glucose levels in diabetic patients should be monitored after injection. The injection may be repeated in 6 weeks if symptoms have not improved. If symptoms do not resolve after the first injection, or recur afterwards, a second injection is typically half as likely to succeed as the initial treatment. If 2 to 3 injections fail to provide adequate resolution, the surgery is the treatment. A procedure called trigger finger release. The trigger finger is released by many ways. Open surgery. Your doctor numbs the area by injecting a local anesthetic into your hand. The advantage of using a local anesthetic is the patient can bend their finger once the release has been performed to ensure the problem is solved. A small, 1 cm, incision is made over the palm of the hand where the tendon is getting stuck. And then he cuts a 1 pulley to give the tendon more room to move and allow it to glide smoothly. The triggering should be immediately resolved. Percutaneous release. You may have this procedure done in your doctor's office using a local anesthetic. Your doctor will insert a sturdy needle into the affected finger's base rather than make an incision, and releases the pulley without directly looking at the pulley and tendon. Then the doctor moves your finger around to check that the motion is smooth. Tenosynovectomy. Your doctor will only recommend this procedure if the first 2 options are not suitable, such as you sustain rheumatoid arthritis. This procedure involves removing part of the tendon sheath, allowing the finger to move freely again. It may also include removal of a part of the tendon. Post-surgery recovery. You will be encouraged to move your finger immediately after surgery. It is common to have some soreness in your palm for a few days. Your doctor may recommend you do specific exercises at home. Most people feel able to drive within 5 days. How soon you can return to work depends on your job. You can return to work after a few days if you work in an office environment. You may not need to take any time off after the day of surgery. If your job involves manual labor, you may need to be off work for up to 2 weeks after surgery. Avoid sports for 2 or 3 weeks until the wound is healed and you have grip strength. Recovery from percutaneous release is typically shorter than for open surgery, allowing patients to return to work sooner. In the next video, I will discuss trigger finger in kids.